In this video, I'm gonna walk you step-by-step on how to set up a countdown timer overlay inside of Ecamm. So the first thing that we're gonna do is inside of Ecamm, we're gonna go ahead and create a scene. So here in our scenes menu, and again, if you don't see your scenes, you'll come to window, you'll click on scenes, and that's gonna open this up here for you. We're gonna hit this little plus icon. We're gonna name this countdown timer. You're going to hit enter, and then we're going to come to source and hit blank. So that's going to be step number one. The next thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to have a countdown timer overlay. And what a countdown timer overlay is a pre-made graphic animated template that has a 5-minute countdown timer that matches your branding, your design, or the game that you're going to be playing. Now, for this example, I'm going to be utilizing a countdown timer overlay from streamdesigns.com, and I'll put a link in the description of this video. Now, Stream Designs has tons of overlays to make your stream look professional, from animated overlays, countdown timers, singer transitions, animated alerts, and you can go ahead and select your countdown timer based on your branding, based on the game you play, to go ahead and match your style. Now, for this example, I'm going to utilize the Zen Zone countdown timer. You're going to see here that it's going to go ahead and count down from 5 minutes and give me a nice animation and branding to make my stream look professional. So once you go ahead and have your countdown timer, we're going to come back here into Ecamm, and we're going to go ahead and get this added. Now, if you went ahead and got your countdown timer from Stream Designs, it's going to come in a zip file. You will double click it. It'll create a folder, and that gives you access to the overlay. Once you have it, there's two ways to be able to add a countdown timer overlay. The first way is to go ahead and select on the countdown timer scene, come to overlays, and then click on this icon here. You're going to find your countdown timer, and you can go ahead and add it here. Hit add animated overlay. You can then make it bigger. And then if you ever want to get rid of these controls here, you can come to Windows, hide made controls. And you'll see here that here you have an option to hide temporarily, hide, loop, or start from the last position. Now, this is the way if you're going to switch to the next scene automatically yourself, this is totally fine to do it this way. However, I prefer that when the timer finishes at zero, it goes to the very next scene, whether it's just chatting or me. And in order for you to achieve that, you want to do it this way. So I'm going to delete this here. I'm going to click my countdown timer. I'm going to come to source, hit blank. Click on window. We want to show our main controls again, and you're going to see a little movie icon here. We're going to click on that. We're going to select choose file. We're going to select our countdown timer. And super important to be able to notice, when you add it this way, it's going to automatically mute your microphone. So you want to make sure that you unmute it so that way you're still able to talk if you choose to. Now, you're going to see you're going to have different options here now when you do it this way. When you click on this little drop-down menu, you're going to see here it's going to say do nothing, loop video, or go to next scene, or even end your broadcast. So we're going to select go to next scene. Now what's going to happen is that, and you want to make sure this is under your starting soon, what's going to happen is that when this gets to the end, you're going to see here that it's going to automatically transition to my just chatting scene. So you give it here. And now it went to my just chatting scene automatically. And that's what you want it to happen. Now, if you want to be able to have a stinger transition, that way when you switch scenes, an animation happens to make it even more professional during your live stream production, go ahead and watch this video right here where I walk you step by step on how to add a stinger transition into Ecamm. I'll see you guys in the next video.